Haiti. It's been a truly memorable year, and I'm truly grateful that all of y'all can be present here this evening with all your families to grace this occasion. For starters, a quick review on all the things we did last year. My apologies to the families, it's going to be a little boring for y'all, but you'll get an idea of what your husbands do day in, day out, okay? So we'll go through a very quick review of last year. For those of y'all who were here last year for our annual meet, the first stats will look familiar. My apologies for that. A quick run through the agenda for the evening. It's quite tight, as you can see. We started on time. This was the chart that I showed a number of you who came to our last presentation. 2002 was a really bad year. What we had effectively done was that we had eroded 4 years of growth. Our RS health was probably the worst. We had the highest instances of check bouncing. There were a couple of unfortunate incidents. And all in all, things weren't looking quite rosy. Rather than a healthy growth card, this is what we had to show for all our effort. In short, at the end of last year, things couldn't have been any worse than they were. And the strange thing that perplexed me was that an area that had such a sterling reputation had suddenly fallen to such abysmal low. The question I kept asking myself was, how could something so right possibly have gone so wrong? And then I chanced upon this famous man who had this to say, that no matter what you do, where you go, or how good you are, everyone needs to take a break. And I'd like to look at that year as precisely that, a breather. And when we last met, I think in infantry court on Jan 24th last year, we all decided that we would change things, that we would all make a difference. And I'm glad to see a number of you who attended that meeting are here today again. And we decided to change that from 2000 to 2003. And I showed you a small clip that time about all the values and all the things that I'd like Karnataka to be known for. And I just want to jog your memory back to show you those things.
Oh.
I can truly put my hand on my heart today and say to all of you that in the course of the last year, across our state, a number of people actually did a number of things that you just saw on that screen. At the end of last year, I had outlined to all of you who had attended our meet, our area sales development plan for the year 2003. I'm just going to take a few minutes to evaluate how we did against the objectives we set out for ourselves at the start of the year. We said we'd grow Pepsodent. We said in hair we'd kill chick because there was serious competition over there. A number of our salesmen present today actually burned chick sachets at our first RS salesman meeting this year. We said we'd drive growth in skin through fal and body lotions. We do a good job of deodorants in Bangalore. And we put the RS salesman at the center of all of this. Very quickly, a look at some of our big successes in my opinion. I think we've done an outstanding job on some shampoo sachets. If you look at our performance across the branch, we've grown the fastest on shampoo sachets. If you look at winter, on a reasonably large base, we've done outstandingly well. If you look at deodorants too, bucking the trend, we're one of the only sales areas in the branch who have actually grown on deodorants too. We have the largest base on Fair and Lovely, and on that we've delivered outstandingly well. The performance on Kimberly Clark has been equally impressive given that we have the largest base. And how will we grow next year? Let's take a quick step back and look at our strategy, because what we did last year basically is where we stuck to our plans and pulled off some huge numbers on the back of it. And we need to continue in that same manner. I had shown you this chart over a year ago and told you that based on share data, based on the size of the markets, based on penetration, and so on, these were the four single largest opportunities for growth in Karnataka. If you look at the skin circle, we have taken 10 crore of that opportunity this year. If you look at shampoos, we have taken 4 crores from that opportunity this year. If you look at deodorants, we've taken about 0.5 crore. The big opportunity that we have missed out on is very clearly paced, and that is the single largest opportunity. And we need to plan and prioritize and focus our efforts to ensure that we take at least 10 crores of this 34 crore opportunity next year. If I was to put up the top 4 tasks for 2004 that I want all of you to take back from today, they would have to be the following. We need to grow the Pepsodent variant, and we need to relaunch Close Up in a manner that has never been done before. The mission in hair remains pretty simple. It's the same thing I asked you to do a year ago. We need to continue to focus on chick, isolate him in every single market and kill him. There really is no option on that. We have to do it. On skin, we need to continue to build a portfolio of body lotion and winter products. There is certainly a market for them throughout the year in Bangalore, as we've seen this year. And we equally need to get growth from all the variants that have been launched in the last year. It isn't in our base for the first half. We need to capitalize on it and make it count. And at the center of it all are RS salesmen. If we were to prioritize everything that we do in terms of focusing on a particular channel or a particular geography or a particular SKU, it would be the following. We need to focus on wholesale. We've recently started a program that builds customer loyalty. It's called Vijeta. We need to focus on Hubli and Metro in particular. And I'm going to be putting in disproportionate time, energy and effort there, because I think the greatest opportunity for growth lies there. We need to ensure that we get 10 crores from oral and 4 crores from hair, because those are the single largest opportunities. In terms of SKUs that we need to drive every single product that was launched in 2003 and we did not do a proper job of. That's crucial. And of course, my plan for the stockist salesman. If you look at where our growth is likely to come from next year, based on the amount of opportunity left in the chart that I showed you 3 charts ago, there's an 8 crore opportunity on skin, a 10 crore opportunity in oral, 5 crore opportunity in hair, a 2 crore opportunity in deos, and a 4 crore opportunity in Ayush. And if we are able to plan, execute and deliver on 4 out of 5 of these tasks, we'll be home and dry for next year, and we'll be the first sales area in the country to breach the 200 crore mark. Okay? And over the last year, we've done a lot of things differently. And I think the person's life that we've managed to impact the most is the stockist salesman. And as we go forward this year, we're going to bring him even closer. And this is part of what we plan to do. We're going to mandate that no stockist salesman in Karnataka PP will draw less than 4,000 bucks a month. Every RS salesman works day in, day out. This is the minimum salary that he deserves. We're going to ensure that we bring some pride into it and make him stand out in the market as a Hindustan Lever salesman and not just any other RS salesman. Equally, we're going to ensure that in our program of lead RS salesmen, we are going to make 2 RS salesmen, the top performers, CA salesmen and later TSI. We need to establish a certain definite career path for them. Just like we aspire to do better, they aspire to. In Metro, handheld terminals are going to be made compulsory. There will not be a single RS salesman in Metro that will not use a handheld terminal. And we will continue to meet regularly and have our 1-2 car for meet. If we are able to do all this, our salesmen will be the most energized, competent, best taken care of, and there is no reason why we won't grow. So very clearly, if we are all focusing on a single person in our sales chain, it has to be the RS salesman.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to 2003 to a marathon race. We have run long and hard, and we are at the end of the race. And as you have just seen, we have run a very good race. And the purpose of our meeting today is to recognize, appreciate, and reward the sweat and toil of each and every one of you. So I deem it my honor to welcome, on behalf of the company, each and every one of you for the annual awards night. We are all gathered together here as one large family. You've got the partners in progress, the RSs. You've got the lead RS salesman sitting at the backside. And we've also got the Dronacharyas, for the other salesmen, led by Mr. Prasanna and also Mr. Sridhar. And of course, all my colleagues, the TSIs and my fellow sales officers. Welcome to all of you. And most importantly, I would also like to welcome the sponsors of all our colleagues here, of the RSS, people who have been the silent and constant support behind these successful men. It also gives me immense pleasure on this occasion to invite our regional sales manager, Mr. Manish Tiwari. Also, we are happy to invite Mr. Kedar Ashley, the area sales manager for Kerala. I will also take this occasion to invite the support staff. I understand Tendul and Samraj are not here. Still, I invite Venkat, our rock, our person in the office who looks after the backside of our operations. And also, we invite the depot planners, Chandru, Muniraj, and Karnamurthy. So welcome to all of you. So sit back and have a great evening. You have earned it.
A few notable milestones that we actually crossed this time at a more branch level perspective, they would have to be these. I want to leave you, before we go on to the awards, with two thoughts really. There was this guy who at one point of time in life said this: we really had only two choices, to stay in a variety store and be hit hard by the discounting wave, or to open a discount store. This gentleman at this juncture made a choice, and he made a choice to open a discounting store, and that choice resulted in what is today the world's largest company. I'm talking about Sam Walton of Walmart. Equally interesting is this quote. It says that the future belongs to those who see possibilities before they become obvious. That gentleman was John Sculley, the former CEO of Pepsi. And the reason I'm sharing these two thoughts with you today is because we have that choice today. We can anticipate the future, choose to be proactive, and make a difference. Equally, we can choose to sit back and let the future decide our fate. The years ahead for all of us are going to be years of huge change, with the environment for retailing in the country undergoing huge upheavals. And it provides us with a unique chance, given that the center of all this change is in our state. And we need to seize this opportunity. Thanks so much for listening. From the bottom of my heart, I owe a deep sense of gratitude to each one of you seated here today, for without your collective effort, we might never have been able to sit over here today and have this awards function. When I had met a number of you last year, we had a similar thing, but it was on a far smaller scale, because there really wasn't anything to celebrate. Each of you have given me tons to celebrate through the last year, and it's been truly outstanding. And I want to thank each of you from the bottom of my heart. It's truly an honor, and an honor of immense magnitude, to be the Area Sales Manager of Personal Products in Karnataka. Thanks. As we go forward, I want to share with you my vision for the future. And by vision, I mean something that I want all of us, individually and collectively, to be known for the next 50 to 100 years. or for all eternity for that matter. So look at this clip. A number of things that you see in this clip actually tie in with what is my vision for all of us today. And that's my vision for each of you. That we will create a sales team that offers our customers the best service, variety and quality of products. We will do so in an ethical manner by doing the right things. We will build relationships that result in raving fan customers, gung-ho employees, pleased third parties and a supportive community at large. We want to be the best sales team in the country. When people think of sales and distribution revitalization, they think of personal products in Karnataka. And people will be flying in from all over the country to find out how we do it. That's where it ties in with the AV. And there are really two lines that I want you to take out from there. The first, that a skeptic sitting in the van said was, "That son of a bitch, he did it." Because what that old gentleman had achieved was something that to the rest of the world was impossible. And the second was what the older gentleman in the van said. He said, "They're going to make a fortune out of this place." And I believe that our company can make a fortune out of the things that we do here today. And that's where it ties in. So I'm just going to run you over that clip again. Watch it carefully. I want everyone who comes to our area to look at what we do with the same astonishment and shock that those people looked at when they saw the dinosaurs. I want everyone to believe that what we do here is truly at the cutting edge of sales, because we can. And we can lead the company. So that then is my vision for each of you in this room today. We've made these small cards that have our vision on it. I want each of you to carry it and believe in it. Because we can do it, and we will. We now move on to our award segment for the evening. And like I promised you, there are a number of performances that we will stand up and applaud today. The people who slave ceaselessly across remote parts of Karnataka, trying to convince an increasingly aggressive trade to buy our products at the cost of others. There was one particular piece that I thought best captured the spirit of all our salesmen. I'm going to call the area sales manager of Kerala, who's been extremely kind to actually come and be with us here this evening. Please welcome Mr. Kedar Apte, area sales manager of Kerala, on stage to distribute the awards to our top RS salesmen. Can I call upon Jagga?
Good evening. Now, our salesmen who made this day a memorable thing. Mr. Shekhar from Bhadravati, Kamath Sales Corporation, Mr. Shekhar from Bhadravati. Mr. Ali from Dana Corporation, Tumkur. Mr. Madan from Hiriyur. Now, Mr. Yatiraj from Growell Enterprises, Mangalore. Across the profit center has been certified by the Dronacharya. Mr.
Mr. Prakash, Vijaya Agencies, Belgaum. Mr. Sunil, Sarur Enterprises, Dharwad. Mr. Hiravan Shashi says Hubli. Mr. Shekhar, Vijaya Agencies, Belgaum. We now move on to Bangalore zone. Katrapani from Srinivas Associates. Gajendra from SD Marketing. Maruti from Burji Marketing. Umesh from Ramnath. Mohan from Dulka Enterprises. Sashi from Ramnath Distributor. Tulsi from Bicom. Basvaraj from Sachin Marketing. Sangri. Rajat Pasha from Ashok Agency. Sunish Padukone from Sigma Agency.
Hello.
LP Vivesh from HI Associates.
That leaves us with the following statistics. We have 300 plus RSASmen in Karnataka. 32 came up and received awards just now. That leaves the top 3 RSASmen in each zone. The real Tendulkar, Dravid and Sehwag of our team. Okay? Through the year, we've been having regular 1-2-4 meets and giving away silver coins. As promised, the best salesman in the year will get, for each zone, a 2.5 gram gold coin certified by Tanishq. So you don't have to worry about Mr. Telgi. More importantly, I think these guys are the guys who we are going to look at making CA salesmen in the near future and migrating to the company. So we haven't clapped loudly thus far, but for these 3 gentlemen, please put your hands together loud and clear. Girish from Surbhi Marketing, Bangalore. Mr. Raju from Hubli Zone. And Mr. Naveen from Shimoga Zone. With that, I'd like to thank Mr. Kedar for standing on the stage for so long. It was probably the longest segment of our awards distribution program. And that, I think, pretty aptly sums up the battles our guys wage every single day in the market. I'd like to call on stage Mr. R. R. Nagendra, the area sales manager, area sales and customer manager for the rural system in Karnataka, and a significant contributor to our performance this year. 20% is no mean amount to contribute, and the rural system has truly stood up to be recognized. The top 2 TSIs in Hubli zone, Mr. Ramesh Kumar and Mr. Prakash Kamal. The top two TSIs in Shimoga zone, Sesha Krishna and my computer's thinking. Subramanya Rai. And the top TSIs in Bangalore, Praveen and Krishnananda. Okay, we have a slight technical glitch. My computer has decided to shut down. So, I want to take this opportunity to bring forward a speech that in any case is pending. So, can I please call Mr. Manish Devani, regional sales, and say a few words.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
You know, I actually meet a lot of sales team across the branch. I know there are people sitting from other sales area over here, including the ASM from Kerala. But there's one thing which I am very clear about, and I actually feel it from the bottom of my heart, that I will always be part of the Karnataka team. You know, whether I get posted to Bombay or whether I get posted outside, one of the key reasons why I am actually here today is, besides the fact that I am the outgoing regional sales and customer manager, is I asked Steve a week back, you know, who all are coming? And I asked him, and I don't know if all the faces are there, but some of the names which came, you know, I asked, I knew that the Bangalore Metro RSS would be there, but I asked him, you know, if Kailash is there. Kailash, are you there in the crowd? Okay, he's not there. And people I have known for the last 6-7 years, some are like Bridge, whom I just met, and I met a lottery king from Belgaum, and I'll never forget the Karnataka team. It's now completely a part of me, and I guess most people in the branch can see that. So whenever there is some issue happening in terms of allocation between areas, I guess most of the ASMs look at me very suspiciously, because they know that somewhere he does have a very strong bias for Karnataka. And it gives me great pleasure to actually see that the team which is so close to my heart has actually delivered an outstanding performance. Something which I was not able to do as an ASM, which is overtake Telangana, which was at that point of time called Andhra Pradesh sales area. Most of you guys would remember the amount of friction we had with the Andhra team trying to be number one. And I'm really happy to see that what was not achievable in the last 3-4 years finally in 2003, all of you guys have become the number one. And actually you guys are the number one in the country also in terms of the quantum added. And the reason I say that is that you might be a crore behind Bihar, but Bihar is going to be invoicing till 31st December. A team which actually delivers maybe a crore less than any other sales area in the country in terms of incremental sale, and actually starts off in a great high on 1st January. According to me, and I am sure according to everyone in the HRL setup, that is the sales team which is actually the number one in the country. The most heartening thing was actually to see the award ceremony starting from the RS salesman. And I have met a lot of distributors and I keep on asking them that, you know, there are a lot of company initiatives like Dronacharya, etc., which have been rolled out. And and how are they working? And it's only in Karnataka where I actually get a feedback from distributors, where the distributors realize the value they can get out of the Dronacharya. And it is of no surprise to actually, when I see the ratings across the brand, that I find most of the RS salesmen in Bangalore actually being put in the top bracket. And it's a reflection of the good effort put by the RS salesmen, the distributors themselves, and the input which has been given by the Dronacharyas. Before I wind up, I have a small a dream for Karnataka. And believe me, even when you guys are having your annual function for 2004 in December next year, I'll still be around, whether I am the regional sales manager or not. I'll definitely come. And I would want to see the 200 crore number on the board. Because I want Karnataka to be the first sales area in the country to cross the 200 crore mark. And then this team, which is one of the best teams in the country today, will actually become a great sales team. A sales team which people will remember for very long. A team which would have delivered 2 years of outstanding growth. Okay? So 200 crores is what I would love to see on the board, maybe a little more than that, when we actually meet again for the 2004 functions. Okay? With that, I guess Mr. Steve's laptop is working again and we will continue with the presentation.
So that's stockist for you, all the complexity, and thanks to all the hard work you guys put in. All of us today can stand like that guy on top of the ship and say we truly are kings of the world. Can I call Manish on stage to distribute the awards to the top stockists in Karnataka? And they're the people who are shaping our markets for growth. We'll start with Hubli Zone. Can we have Pramod Agencies, Raghavendra Enterprises, Vijay Agencies, Srinivasa Agencies, Vasava Agencies, Gopal Agencies and JCD Marketing on stage, please? Pramod Agencies, they were the fastest growing RS in Hubli Zone for the full year. Can you please come on stage? last but by no means the least, the top stockist in Bangalore zone, Sri Ramnath, Sachin Marketing, SD Marketing, Dwarka Brothers, Srinivasa Agency, Srinivasa Associates, Durga and Surabhi. For Sri Rama Distributors, they're the fastest growing stockist in Bangalore zone. In the entire branch and being the fastest growing zone in Chennai branch. Jagga, can you please come on stage? And not far behind at 12.2%, Freddie, the sales officer of Bangalore zone. Equally significant in this entire scheme of things are a number of people who we never see on the front. They're the men behind the action. Invisible to the untrained eye, they're the people who work ceaselessly to grease our daily routines and make our lives that much more simple. There's one person who I always referred to as Karnataka's rock, the only constant, the single source for all data. If you are in a spot of trouble, there's one person you turn to, and that's my rock. Can I have Venki on stage, please? Say to you in conclusion, spread the light, because your candle never loses anything when it lights another. I think we all have a lot to learn from each other. We've learned a lot over the last year, and we're going to do even greater things in the year ahead. So thanks a ton. It's been an outstanding evening. The bar will open in 5 minutes from now. Dinner is being served both inside and outside. Please have a good feed, and thanks for coming. In typical Tamilian style, where I spend most of my life in Madurai, whenever people are going, they always say, "Poyittu vaanga." So the same thing I say to you today, "Poyittu vaanga." See you all next year in 2004. One second.
Bogi Bunny.
Okay, guys, before we wind up, the last and the final bit before dinner and drinks, I think we thank almost every person
who belongs to the Karnataka team, who's helped the Karnataka team, whether from the branch, whether from the RS community, the KSI community, the RS salesmen. And we thank the ASM, Mr. Remedios. But I think there are two people who have just entered the hall, who I personally believe, and I'm sure all of you will agree with me, deserve a huge round of applause, and I will call them up on stage right now. Mr. and Mrs. Remedios, can I have you on stage, please? Capable area sales manager for Hindustan Unilever at least. Okay, let's have dinner now, guys.